In this screencast, we're going to use an example problem to demonstrate how pressures lead to forces acting on an object. We have sparkling cider bottles that can actually reach pressures of around 80 psig. What is the estimated initial acceleration of the cork when it's opened? We're going to use the assumption that the cork is 1 inch diameter by 2 inches high and has a density of 7.22 times 10 to the negative third pounds mass per inch cubed. So in a problem like this, it's always best to start with the schematic and to know what we're looking for. Since we're asked to find the estimated initial acceleration, we could use the relationship that a force is a mass of an object times its acceleration. Therefore, to find the acceleration, we're going to look for the force and divide it by its mass. In this problem, we're not given any information about the angle at which this cork is opened. So let's just assume that we're looking at the acceleration for a cork that's opened completely vertical. So we're looking for the acceleration in the y direction, and we're going to look for the forces in the y direction that's going to cause this. So now let's draw our cork and do a force balance of the forces acting in the y direction only on this cork. So let's say we have our cider bottle. So we know we have a pressure force acting on the surface of the top part of the cork due to the atmospheric pressure, and a pressure force acting on the bottom surface of the cork due to the pressure within the bottle. We also know that we have the weight of the cork acting downwards, and those are our three main forces acting on this cork. We could also draw the dimensions that we're told. We know that the diameter is 1 inch, and the height of the cork is 2 inches. So to calculate our overall force in the y direction, we're going to look at the summation of the forces acting in the y direction. And so we could do this one of two ways. We could do this either using absolute pressure, or we could do this using gauge pressure. And we could do this because if we look at the force due to the atmospheric pressure, then we know the absolute pressure acting on the top surface is going to be that of atmosphere. So the pressure times the area will give us our force. Now this is acting in a downwards direction, so we're going to say that downwards is going to be a negative force. And so if then we add the positive force due to the pressure inside the bottle, we're going to have the gauge pressure plus that of atmosphere to give us our absolute pressure. This times our area will give us the force acting upwards on the cork. Then we could take into consideration the weight force, which is acting downwards. So our force balance would look like the following. And what you'll notice is that if we distribute our terms, this negative P atmosphere times area will be canceled by this positive P atmosphere times area. So therefore, sometimes it's easier to just work with gauge pressures. If we do that, the gauge pressure acting on the top surface of the cork is just zero since it's atmospheric pressure. So we get rid of that term and just focus on the following force balance. So this simplifies it greatly, and at this point we look at the terms that we have and figure out what we know and what we don't know. In the problem statement, we're given a gauge pressure inside the bottle of 80 psi. We know the diameter of the cork is 1 inch, so we could calculate the area at which this pressure acts. Now we're not given the weight of the cork. We could calculate the weight of the cork as the mass of the cork times gravity. And the mass can be written as the density of the cork times the volume. We're given the dimensions of the cork, so we know the volume. We're also given the density of the cork in the problem statement. So as you can see, we could calculate the mass of the cork and we know gravity. So now we know the weight of the cork. So at this point, it's just a matter of calculating the summation of our forces, plugging them into our acceleration equation using the mass of our cork, and we can estimate what we think the initial acceleration of this cork would be. So the sum of the forces in the y direction is going to be equal to the gauge pressure times our cross-sectional area. So this is pi times our radius squared. We could either work in feet or inches. Since we're given inches already, I'm just going to stay in inches. And so this is going to be 0.5 inches squared minus our density, this density times our volume. So our cross-sectional area, pi times 0.5 inches squared times our height of 2 inches will give us our volume of the cork times gravity, which in this case is 32.174 feet per second squared. So we need to convert that to inches to make sure our units match up. Now, one important thing before we completely finalize this is that this right term, the rho vg, is using pounds mass, whereas the left term, our pressure in area, is using a pound force. So we need a conversion between pounds force and pounds mass. And we know that 1 pound force is equal to 32.174 pounds mass times a foot per second squared. So we need to use this conversion factor on our right term, our weight term, to make sure that we are consistent and have both dimensions of these two terms in pound force when we finish. So to make this conversion work, we'll divide that term by the 32.174 pounds mass foot per second squared. And again, to notice, since we're working with feet in this conversion, we also have to convert to inches to make sure that everything works out. And so we'll use the same conversion factor we did above. Now that we have all our unit conversions correct, we can simplify this problem. So when we do the calculations, we should get the following. So as you can see, the sum of the forces in the y direction is really not dependent on the weight of the cork since it's so small. And so our final answer will be 62.82 pounds of force. And so we're going to use this in our acceleration calculation, dividing that by the mass of the cork. So the acceleration is going to be equal to 62.82 pounds divided by the mass of the cork, which was the density, times the volume. And so as you see, our units will not match up. We need to use the conversion factor between pounds force and pounds mass. And so now when we calculate our acceleration in the y direction, we'll get 178,000 feet per second squared, which is a very high acceleration. To give you a sense of magnitude, a bullet leaving a gun has an acceleration of roughly 1.3 million feet per second squared, plus somewhere about that. So this is about an order of magnitude different from the acceleration of a bullet out of a gun, but does give you an idea that the pressure forces within these carbonated bottles can produce some pretty high forces on these corks.